This is Ashton Marcus, and I'm on location at Rogue Machines Met Theater for the West Coast premiere of Still Life.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. And I'm here with?
Oh, I'm Michael Poretti. I'm director of Still Life by Alex Vidalaris.
Question, why do you decide to do this?
Well, Alex and I, we had a professional relationship some time ago. I was an agent and he was my client. And I fell in love with this play when he wrote it. And there was a time when he said he was going to do it as a movie. He held off the rights, but he said, Michael, you go ahead and do this in Los Angeles at the Rogue Machine. So I have this wonderful opportunity now to do the Los Angeles premiere of Still Life for him.
I thought it was wonderful. Well, first of all, I have a question. Those pictures added so much, because again, this is about a photographer. What happened? When you get the script, do they give you a pack of pictures, or do you have to come up with your own images?
That is totally our addition to the script. There's nothing indicated except for the dead animals in the gallery. Otherwise, John Flynn, who is the artistic director here, is also a photographer. So he is really responsible for that concept of having those images between scenes. Photographs that are from collections, from sometimes from members of the cast, but those are all his idea about having the transitions with those photographs that she might have taken.
I really love the piece. I thought it was about, well, basically it was a snapshot of life, you know, almost a picture of life. An album, as you might put it, and it was actually so clear, so real, and actually had a story from beginning to end.
Yes, and I think it's a really, I love the play because what I do in the theater is direct those plays where maybe there's some things we should think about. I'm a total agnostic. The moment before I was born and the moment after I die, I really don't know what that is. This may be all we have. So this is not a dress rehearsal. This is it, some people have said. And I think the play helps people think, well, what am I doing? Because tomorrow I might die from a car accident, or God knows, people younger than me have died. It makes you wonder, how much more time do I have? What do I want to do with it? I hope the play may stimulate some people thinking about that.
What did you look for in your casting in this
well,
piece?
Well, certainly Laurie and Jennifer are two actresses I've worked with in the past. I knew their work. But 80% of direction is casting. And I have the wonderful wealth of so many actors that were so great auditioning. This is kind of like, I could have done this, cast this play two or three times with the actors that came to try out for me. And it really is about what we all work with together in terms of the technical challenges that this play demands. It was very important to have actors who knew what their character was, what they wanted, so that when the technical problems started to happen, it didn't matter, because they knew no matter what. They knew who they were, and they knew what they wanted. And you succeeded, I hope.
Once again, I really love the piece. I thought it had a wonderful message, something that people, I guess, everyone identifies with, and a lot of people just don't think about what they really should. So once again, I really love the piece. I really love the way you directed it. Thank you very much for being on the show.
You're very welcome. Thank you for coming.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. I'm here with
Laurie Okun. I am from Massachusetts. I've been in LA for about 20 years. I played the character of Carrie Ann Daly. She's a photographer who is struggling with the recent death of her father, and she finds herself unable to pick up a camera because she can't deal with the fact that she's more talented than he was. I think she's very down to earth, very grounded, very no nonsense, and I think she's not someone who shows her feelings. She's someone who covers them with anger and with this sort of hard shell, and then she meets this guy who she ends up really lowering her guard with. Ultimately, it's the redemption of sort of claiming who you are and your place difference in the world and the fact that we all have to live. The world has to go on.
I'm very interested in the arts, obviously because of what we do and all that. Very interested in the arts. Your character was this type of this prodigy. Kind of couldn't really fit in her skin, but actually just had the art kind of flowing through her. What's your take on that?
I always think that that's a double-edged thing, because I do think there is such a thing as inspiration, something very ethereal about art, but there also is something that must be very disciplined about it, and we must be able to draw on ourselves without relying on some whimsy of inspiration that may or may not strike at any given time. A writer has to sit down and write. A photographer has to take pictures. It's not just our craft, it's also our livelihood. So we have to approach it that way. And so I think a healthy balance of those two things and respect for both of those two things is crucial.
I really love the way you played it. I could really feel the emotion in it. And the audience was connected to it also. I don't want to give away too much about the ending, but it was actually extremely touching. It talked a great deal about life.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. It's the kind of ending that you really want to handle with nothing but the most genuine, authentic touch, because it has to be real. It just has to be real.
Once again, I really love your performance. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you very much. Nice meeting you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM Irvine, and I'm here with
Lee Coco. I play Jeff in Still Life. You know, he starts to play a little bit of a lost soul. He's had a rough go of it his whole life. He's a little bit of a bruised and abused personality. And he gets some very surprising news, and he meets the love of his life all in a very short span of time, and it rocks his world, and it changes his perspective, and he learns to live, he learns to love.
I really love this piece. I thought it was fantastic. I thought it was like a picture album of a person's life. And this is like the only truth a person really has. The only objective truth a person has is that picture album. What are your thoughts on that?
One of the things that I love about the play that I think you're talking about is its episodic nature. And the fact that its narrative is not, it's a linear narrative, but it's told in patches. And it's almost like you get distilled the most important aspects of these people's lives in this moment. And so it's like a picture album, it's like a quilt, and it all adds up in the aggregate to be this really moving, beautiful story.
I also love the dialogue that you guys had. I mean, the way you guys delivered it, the depth of it, the command of language you guys had. I thought it was excellently done.
Yeah, thanks. You know, that's actually, I love it too. It's an amazing journey to go on. I have to say it is incredibly difficult to learn stuff like that because it's very easy to paraphrase, you know? But Alex had a lot of intention, and the longer I do the play, the more I realize that even within this sort of colloquial world that he's created with the dialogue, every word counts. It all matters.
Without giving away too much of the story, if my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
They should expect to see a piece about renewal, and they should expect to leave the theater feeling empowered and feeling like they have a second chance at doing things right.
I really loved your performance. I love the performance of everyone as a whole. I thought it was fantastic. I love the story. It was actually a very deep, meaningful story, too. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Hey, man. My pleasure. Thanks for coming.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine. I'm here with
Susan Wilder. I'm a member of Rogue Machine Theater, and this is the first play I've actually done here since I've been a member for 6 years, because they do amazing work here. I play Joanne in Still Life, and I love characters who say things like, what is this, a conversation? Just do it. She doesn't have time to work with people. She does what she does. She's an artist, and she has a good eye, and she knows other artists.
I loved your character, the way you portrayed it.
I'm so glad.
Yeah, you kind of remind me of maybe the boss I really want to have, you know?
Very good.
Very strong female character. I love the power you put yeah. in it. I love the authority you gave it. I love the kind of the direction, because you were moving the characters the way they were. So I just thought you did a fantastic job.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Once again, I really love the piece. I love the performance. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KVCI 88.9 FM in Irvine. I'm here with...
I'm Jonathan Bray.
I'm from Boston. I spent about 7 years in New York training and doing a lot of theater there, and I came out to L.A., 15 years ago, and, you know, it's just been out here ever since. I played Terry. Terry is a guy who is damaged and is compensating for that damage. And has a voracious appetite for life in every way, and ultimately that gets the best of him.
I love the way you played your character. Your types of characters really add a lot of flavor, basically, to the place. It was a quirky character, but also it spoke so much shocking things about his background. You know?
Yeah, for sure. I'm glad that came through, because that was important. You know, Michael and I, the director, talked about how you have to make sure that Terry isn't just a villainous asshole. You know, he has to have some humanity to him. Otherwise, I don't think there's a point to have him in the play, you know? So I'm glad that came through.
Well, I think it was kind of a contrast, too, also, because this is what real life is. Life is dirty. Life is gritty. Life is full of people like these. This is life. I mean, he's just as much of life as everyone else is.
I couldn't agree more, you know? And so obviously, as an actor, you never judge your character, and that's how I see it. It's like, look, this is, you know, hey, that's just, like, that's how I am. That's the way it is. You know, you don't do your job, you're gone, right? That's life.
Once again, I really loved your character. Well, first of all, one more thing. If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
It's a beautifully written play about life, about the people facing their own mortality, people dealing with the idea of what is a relationship and what do I want from life. You know, it's definitely not a light comedy, but there's a lot of funny moments in it.
Yeah. Once again, I love the piece. I love the way you played it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you. Take care.
Well, hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI 88.9 FM in Irvine. And I'm with
Frank Collison. I'm a character actor. I've been in the business a long time. I'm one of those people that sometimes get stopped on the street and say, you look vaguely familiar. But my background, my home is theater. I've been doing theater since I was a kid. And I've been in L.A. since 1984, and I have three wonderful kids and a wonderful wife named Laura Gardner. I played Theo. That is Carrie Ann's father, and I appear in two scenes, one in the first act, one in the second act, and I think I'm pretty much in her dreams, at least on stage. I relate to the character. I think a lot of people, men, I don't know, women too probably, but men are so obsessed with their career and how successful they are that as they approach the end of their lives, as my character is, they begin to question whether they did anything worthwhile. So as an actor, you know, you're always dealing with rejection and the next job, so the transfer was not difficult to make between being a photographer and being an actor, as far as questioning your life and whether you've achieved anything worthwhile.
If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
I don't like to say much about a play. I think they should expect to see a very thought-provoking play that, you know, I think if they're younger, they'll get a whole different take than if they're my age, which will remain a deep, dark secret. But I think different ages will take it different ways. You know what I learned tonight in the opening night? There's a lot of humor in this show. Even though it deals with very serious subjects, there were a lot of laughs.
The writer was very witty. He was incredibly witty and very good timing. You all had very good comic timing.
Well, you know, he was one of the writers on Birdman, which also is a very serious movie, but very funny as well. So I think you see that.
I really loved your performance, and I thought you did very well. I love the performance of everyone as well. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. I knew it.
Jennifer Sorensen. I've been here for about 20 years. I went to Loyola Marymount University, and I've done LA theater for about 15 years, and it's amazing. I play Al, Michaeline, and Mary. They're sort of the whole spectrum of feminism. That's what I take on it. It goes from being a one woman who wants to be no gender at all, named Al, to a woman who's named after a boy, Michaeline, who dresses, what some would say, inappropriately. And Mary is kind of in the middle, trying to balance it all. That's what I would say.
If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
A play about life and choosing to live.
I really love this piece. I think it really touched deep meaning of things which people just don't look at, which everyone has to learn, you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, it does. It does. And it kind of dissects what life and death actually is. And you can look at it in different ways and decide how you choose to feel about it, and either to live your life or not.
I really love the piece. I thought there was a lot of dignity in it. It dealt with the subject very well. Masterfully of language. I thought the language was fantastic. I thought it was, you know, the writing. The writing was fantastic. What are your thoughts on that?
Alexander is an amazing writer. His writing is like music. And it doesn't leave room to mess up anything, because if you mess up one note, then the entire orchestra gets confused. So yeah, the writing is absolutely beautiful.
Once again, I really love the piece. I love your performance in it also. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. And I'm here with
Alexandra Hellquist. I am a multi-ethnic mutt. I've lived in 7 countries. I'm here in LA now, and I love it. And we're just coming off the opening night for Still Life at Rogue Machine, and I think we kick it. And I'm so proud to be part of this production. And yeah, come see it. It's great. I actually play 3 characters. I play Lena, Nina, and Sandra. And it's been a real trip exploring the specificities of these different characters and how they all kind of get consumed in different ways by this other character named Terry. But you'll have to come and see us to find out more. I do think it's a really interesting path to trace each of these different characters who only appear very, very quickly, but who have this like common thread of having to exist in a man's world. And I would say this other character, Terry, is almost Trumpian in a certain sense. So I think that it's very pertinent in this particular time in American history to explore those themes of what it means to have to be a woman, to be pretty, to be good, to be consumed and to find power, hopefully. I'm not sure that my characters do, but other characters in the play do, which is very important and satisfying.
If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
I think it's a meditation on love and art and finding light in the darkness and taking your broken heart and making it into art and choosing to live even when it's difficult. And I think that those are important things for us all to remember right now.
I thought you were fantastic in the show.
Thank you.
I loved everyone in the show. I thought the meaning of the show was actually very deep.
Yeah.
It was almost like an album. Everyone's life in the snapshots of an album, but that was their life. It was the true, raw truth of exactly what it was.
That means a lot to hear. Thank you. That means a lot.
Thank you once again for being on the show.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. And I'm here with
Tanya Verifield. I am a Los Angeles native who's a proud Rogue Machine member for the last 9 years. I play the role of Jesse, the photography student. Jesse is a very enthusiastic and emotional, talented young photographer who's looking for a mentor, and she finds that in Carrie Ann.
If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
A really moving piece about what it is we do with our lives when we feel all is lost.
I love the piece. I thought it was very artistic. Not only did it actually talk about, again, you know, I don't want to give away too much of the ending, but basically about a person's life, but it also delved a great deal into the art, too, of how, you know, how pictures kind of are the only thing that are almost real, because it's kind of like capturing your soul, you know what I mean?
I absolutely love that. First of all, thank you for coming to the show and enjoying it, and I agree, I think this piece has a lot to say about the arts, and especially photography, and what it is that it's able to capture that any other art cannot.
I really love the way you played your character. I could see you as being the student, the kind of the ingenue. I thought you played it really well, and I actually enjoyed the performance a lot. I really loved it. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you so much for asking me.
Hi, my name is Ashton Marcus. I'm with KUCI, 88.9 FM in Irvine. I'm here with...
Hi, Nardeep Kermi. I play Sean in Still Life at Rogue Machine. I'm an actor and a writer and a director living in Los Angeles. Was born in Switzerland, grew up in Philadelphia, schooled in New York, and out here now. It's my Rogue Machine debut. Super excited about it. Thrilled to share this amazing piece with everybody. I play Sean. Sean is Jeff's rock, for lack of a better term, right? Like, he's the one that Jeff always goes to when he's in trouble, when he goes to when he needs advice. And he's his brother. He's there for him. He's been there for him his whole life. And, you know, he's going to be there for him at the end of his life, too. So Sean is kind of like Jeff's rock. That's how I would describe him.
If my viewers decide to come by and see this piece, what should they expect to see?
Oh, man. If your viewers decide to come see this show, I expect them to see something that's very life-fulfilling. You're going to see two characters who are struggling with just getting through everyday life, and I think watching them go through their journey and struggle with the idea of how do I live, how do I move forward with tragedy in my life while connecting with each other, you know, in this beautiful way, I think the audiences, though it's a very sad show, are hopefully will see it as a very sort of uplifting, life-fulfilling thing where they'll see it and say, hey, I can live my life even if I've been experienced tragedy, or I'm going to experience tragedy, as we all will at some point. They will, you know, be like, I can get through it, you know, with the love of my friends and family and all of that. So hopefully that's what they experience when they see it.
Well, I really liked the piece. I loved it. I liked your performance in it. I thought it was a piece of, well, first of all, of basically what your life is. It's like a still, it's like an album, basically. Mm-hmm. Series of pictures, series of events. But basically, these series of events is what basically your life is. It's the truth, the real truth of what you are.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's you know, I think Alexander de Larise wrote this, and what I think he really captured is a very contemporary slice of culture. And this is what we, like, a lot of us live like, you know, especially, and, you know, I hate to bring politics into it, but like Trump America, you hear about the bubble in the cities. I mean, this is kind of very much indicative of that. You know, we go see art and we talk about feminism and things like that. And I think one of the beauties of this is the language is very modern and contemporary. The characters are very modern and contemporary. And they are dealing with all of these very heavy issues while living in the world that we're living in right now. So these characters could easily be your brother, your sister, your best friend, or, you know, the guy in the subway or the girl, you know, on the bus that you're sitting next to, which I think is really lovely. And I think that's something that I really get drawn to, particularly when you're seeing theater. You know, you rarely get to see contemporary theater that speaks to today, right now, in the moment. And I think this is like lands. It's a sort of like it is of today. It is a piece of today, and I think that's really lovely.
Once again, I really love the piece. I really enjoyed your acting. Thank you very much for being on the show.
Thank you very much. Everybody, come out and see it. Still Life, Rogue Machine.
Still Life will be playing at Rogue Machine's Met Theater from March 11th to April 23rd. For more information, go to www.roguemachinetheater.net.